So it's just an thank you, person, for a nice words. So it's just an extension of Dr. Vinod Mittal's talk. So pharmacotherapy in obesity management and when to refer for bariatric surgery. So first of all, greetings to all of you from Bangalore. So if you take the current management strategy, so the three things are there. The first thing is the dietary advice. The second is physical activity and lifestyle change, the behavioral therapy and education, pharmacotherapy, and the bariatric surgery. So physical activity and lifestyle change, obviously it goes lifelong, as well as the behavioral therapy and education. So if you take the obesity, the treatment according to the BMI category, this is an important aspect to be noted. In international, the body mass index are different compared to India. So internationally, you can see that the topmost one where you're seeing that 25 to 26.9, and the division is like that. So the thing is, diet, exercise, and behavior will be part of all the irrespective of the body mass index. Pharmacotherapy starts if the BMI is between 27 and 29.9. with comorbidities and in the rest of the things. Bariatric surgery is between like 35 to 39 in international one, whereas in Asian, you can see our Asian Indians at 32.5 with comorbidities, you can think of referring to bariatric surgery, or if more than 40 directly or more than 37.5 in the Asian Indians directly referred to pharmacotherapy. So when to start pharmacotherapy in obese management? First step is lifestyle modification. If there is no desirable weight loss for 3 to 6 months, start with pharmacotherapy. So if body mass index of more than 30 BMI or BMI of 27 or more with two or more comorbidities, that is hypertension, diabetes, or prediabetes, so in addition to lifestyle modification, start with the pharmacotherapy. The pharmacotherapy, the principles is the reduced food energy intake, increased energy expenditure, and the combination of both. You see, as seen in this slide, so many have gone to graveyard, that is rimonabant, fenfluramine, sibutramine, and dexaflo. The latest one was lorcaserin in last year. So lorcaserin is removed from the market in 2020 for increased risk of cancer. So what are the drugs approved for chronic weight management? That is only Arlistat is available in India. Then is the phentermine and topiramate, naltrexone and bupropion, liraglutide 3 milligram, semaglutide 2.4 milligrams once a week. So medications for obesity management, the 5 FDA approved medications are Arlistat and phentermine topiramate combination, bupropion naltrexone combination, and liraglutide. The further categorized by their approved length of use is short term, generally 12 weeks or less, and long term use or chronic use. The main thing you should remember is pregnancy remains the common contraindication for all. So how much weight loss one can expect? For FDA approval of drug efficacy, a drug has to meet one of the following parameters: the placebo subtracted weight loss of more than 5% at the end of 1 year. So more patients in the intervention arm lose more than 5% as compared to the placebo. The pharmacotherapy, there are 4 broad categories. One is the peripherally acting agent. The second one is the agents modifying homeostatic regulation of food intake and energy expenditure. That is both central and peripheral actions. The agents that inhibit food intake by acting on the brain's reward centers. So if you go for the first one, Arlistat, as Dr. Vinod Mittal has explained about this, it has been approved for long-term use. You can expect in the year, the weight reduction may be 10.6, but if you can see on the extreme left side, by year 4, it is 5.8 kgs. So along with the weight reduction, the important aspect we know is the diabetes prevention. It is one of the studies shows, the 4-year studies, which shows the risk of developing type 2 diabetes was 37% lower in those treated with Arlistat. Now, coming to the next mode of action, that is the phentermine short-term use. This is one of the interesting things which has been rampantly used in US. Mechanism of action is increases the energy expenditure and appetite suppression. You can expect up to 3.6 kg weight loss. Only thing, the problem with these drugs are the side effects like palpitations, tachycardia, blood pressure variation, insomnia, dry mouth, overstimulation. Sometimes if you see this side effect, you really feel that whether you need to prescribe these medications to our patient. So this is the combination of phentermine and topiramate. It, once again, the mechanism of action, it suppresses the appetite, improves the satiety, increases the energy expenditure. You can expect weight loss of up to 6.6 to 8.6 kg in 1 year. The common side effect is dizziness, paresthesia, dysgeusia, insomnia, and dry mouth. This is a combination that is called a SIMEA, phentermine and topiramate combination. It's US FDA approved. It's a combination of two things. Next important aspect is the GLP-1 RA, which is, we all know about the GLP-1 RA, how it is useful, right? How the mechanism of action takes place, and how it does. The only thing is the dosage of this particular molecule is very important. You can always start with 0.6 milligram, titrate to 1.2, 1.8, and go up to 3 milligram as recommended by the FDA for the weight loss. So 3 milligram is the recommended dosage. You can expect up to 5.8 kg reduction in 1 year. So that is the plus point of GLP-1 RA. You can see in this slide, liraglutide for weight loss in obese patient. You can see the weight reduction compared to placebo and orlistat. Liraglutide 3 milligram has a significant weight reduction as shown in this slide, up to 7 to 8 kgs. So coming to the another mode of action with this, this is the naltrexone and bupropion therapy. It's once again recommended for the long-term use. It suppresses the appetite, basically. So basically, if you think, if you do the diet, that is it. There is nothing to do. All these drugs are indirectly acts by suppressing the appetite. So you can expect 4.9 kgs reduction in 1 year. The problem with these drugs are the side effects. If you see the side effects, it is really like headache, constipation, diarrhea, nausea, insomnia, blood pressure variability. If you think certain things, like in conditions like persons with hypertension, you can use it. So you need to monitor the blood glucose as well in patients with type 2 diabetes. You can see in this slide, it's an interesting slide to see the comparative efficacy of weight loss medication. What is the percentage of weight loss you can expect here? Among these, the standout is the phentermine and topiramate. You can see on the blue color, when even better than liraglutide, naltrexone, larcaserine, and orlistat. So our age-old drug, we should always not forget, that is metformin. You can see in this slide, during the DPP clinical trial also, the participants randomized to metformin experienced an average 2.1 kg weight loss. I'm sure all of us who have put in our patient, in diabetic patient, we would have seen the weight reduction along with the good diabetes control. So metformin also plays a role, but is it recommended? No, off-label you can use it, but definitely it is not the thing. Sometimes what happens as you use metformin in other conditions like PCOD and all, so in the same way, you can use in obesity management also. But explaining to the patient is very, very important. The next is the blockbuster molecule in last couple of years, that is the SGLT2 inhibitors. We have got three things, Cana, Dapa, EMPA, which has shown a good weight reduction. The important aspect is now the bariatric surgery. Like, this is always an important thing. Most of the patients will ask you, and what is the recommendation? When to refer? That is very complications and financial constraint. So ladies and gentlemen, to conclude my talk, with these new drugs in development, anti-obesity therapeutics have a potential to vastly expand, allowing the better treatment options and personalized approach to obesity care. With more and more agents that may be made available, pharmacotherapy will be an important adjunct to lifestyle modification in the near future. Customization of anti-obesity treatment may soon become a reality. Thank you for your patience, Eric.